Welcome back to Soda City Live, everyone. Tomorrow, there's going to be some great barbecue offered up here in Columbia, so you don't have to worry about lunch or dinner, but we do want you to know that it's for a great cause. The Columbia chapter of the National Federation of the Blind of South Carolina is teaming up with Little Pigs Barbecue for their 68th, yes, 68 years. They've been holding an annual barbecue fundraiser. The purpose behind it, just remarkable. Joining me today is the Columbia chapter of the National Federation of the Blind. We have the past president here, Frank Kopel, and the current chapter president, Isaiah Nelson. Gentlemen, thank you both. Thank you so much for being here today.
You're quite welcome.
Really appreciate it. We were talking before the break, and you were sharing all of the great things the Federation does for people that are struggling with their vision. But before we start with that, I want you to share with our viewers your personal story about blindness. And Frank, we can start with you.
Sure. Glad to. I became totally blind when I was about age 15 years of age. I'm originally from Baltimore, Maryland, mm-hmm. and grew up there. And I guess about my senior year in college, I was dating a girl. We used to have readers back in those days. Mm-hmm. You know, nothing was on computer back in the early 70s. So I had a young lady, and we became friendly. We started to date. I went home to meet her parents, and she didn't tell them I was blind or anything, so I freaked them out, I think, when I walked in the door, and they completely freaked out and put a bad taste in my mouth, and so to speak, felt kind of defeated. I never was told that I was different or less of a person before. And so I got involved with this group, the National Federation of the Blind in Baltimore, and they taught me that basically that blindness is not the characteristic that defines me or my future. And they also taught me that we need to raise our expectations, because low expectations can create obstacles to our future and to our dreams. And they also said, if you learn the skills, alternative skills, you can live the life you want, and blindness is not going to hold you back. And that's what the Federation for the Blind has done for me over the past almost 50 years.
Wow.
I moved to South Carolina in 1975 mm-hmm. with the South Carolina Commission for the Blind, worked there for 28 years, had a family, now have grandchildren. So I've kind of living the American life and the American dream, and I think a lot of it's due to the National Federation of the Blind.
Frank, thank you so much for sharing that story, and I love the points that you made. I know that someone else is watching who may be dealing with the same thing and feel motivated by what you just said. And Isaiah, I'll ask you the same question if you can share your story.
Okay, mine's going to be a real long story, but I'm going to try to make it short.
Oh, okay, you can make it short for us.
But I am born blind with a family of seven, partially totally blind, our brothers and sisters. Mm-hmm. There were six of us went to the South Carolina School for the Deaf and Blind up in Spartanburg back in 1969. I was about 12 to 13 years old when I went to school there, for the simple reason is there was welfare in Georgetown, South Carolina, where I was from. Mm-hmm. And they were always saying that the school was full, but the blessing of a young lady from Orlando, Florida came up and got us in the school, and there we are at 12, 13 years old, first time I was able to learn how to spell my name, to write my name, and to read a book or anything like that. But through the South Carolina School for the Deaf and Blind, I was able to find out about the Federation as the Royal Club back in the days. So I didn't know that it was the Federation until after I finished school. Well, I left school back in the late 70s, went to work, because after being a certain age, then you could not continue to go to the school. So I was able to learn about 6 years of education. And from there, I done what Mom has always told me, said, you know, common sense is good, and knowledge and learning how to do things and to manage better than money and all that kind of good stuff. So she kind of filled me in and let me know just the way you live your life, it makes a difference in this world today.
Right.
So even without what I would call a high school graduation, I have been my own business owner for about 39 years and all that kind of good stuff. I retired, which I worked in the vendors program.
And Isaiah, thank you so much. I don't want to cut you off, but we are wrapping up with time here, and I
right.
want to make
see,
sure
that's
that
like
no, no, no. I appreciate that, and I want to make sure that we tell people too about the barbecue tomorrow.
Right.
But I wanted to establish your personal stories, because I want people to really grasp the understanding of what this barbecue fundraiser is about. So gentlemen, thank you both so much for sharing that with us. So tomorrow, 68th annual barbecue fundraiser. Congratulations on 68 years. Where is this going to be at? And tell us more about what the funds will be going toward.
This is going to be at 119 South Kilburn Road, right off of Rosewood. Mm-hmm. And your marketplace would be Marco's Pizza, turn right there. And the Federation for the Blind is like one block away with a big sign sitting out in front.
All right, good. And then when people come and they purchase a plate, you were telling me all the amazing things that the funds will go toward. And Frank, what would that be?
Sure. We provide a college scholarship for a high school individual. We also provide transportation to our members to and from our meetings and so forth. And also we tried to give them a stipend to go to our national and state conventions so they can learn more about the assistive technology that's out there, as legislation and other educational choices for them.
That's amazing. And it's going to be in Houston this year, the national convention, right?
Right. There'll be about 3,000 blind folks in Houston from all over the country and basically all over the world. And it's pretty amazing to see the canes going around and service dogs. And it's pretty cool.
That's amazing. And Isaiah, as the president, what would you like for the community to know about the importance of making sure that they support this fundraising event tomorrow?
Because this is what we use to, again, to get the blind to meetings with the van that we have and to get the money to take care of those vans and to get the Rocky Bottom Camp for the Blind up in Pickens and to our state convention, which is coming up in August at the Embassy Suite here in Columbia. Mm-hmm. And many more things. Just try to make sure that when a blind person come in, they know they have support.
And you don't have to be blind to support. You need people outside of your community as well to support.
Yes.
We have many sighted members who join us, and they're a major part of our group and so forth.
Well, great. Well, gentlemen, thank you so much for coming on. We really appreciate you for talking to us, sharing your personal stories, and talking about the importance of the 68th Annual Barbecue Fundraiser tomorrow. We're going to pull up all the details yet again so that you can make sure that you are in the number. Again, this is for the Columbia chapter of the National Federation of the Blind. This event happening on South Kilburn Road, not too far from the Marco's Pizza right here in Columbia, tomorrow from 12 to 8. $12 a ticket, but it's going towards so many things to help the blind community. We will make sure to have this full interview on SodaCityLive.com. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be right back. Awesome.